The XRP Ledger has achieved remarkable milestones, surpassing 83 million ledgers, marking a significant point in its 11-year journey since inception. This highlights the incredible growth and evolution of the permissionless blockchain, offering fast, cost-effective transactions for a wide array of use cases. The accomplishment was first brought to light by XRP Scan, a prominent XRPL chain explorer, in a recent post, confirming the event on October 5, 2023, at precisely 3:52 UTC. This 83 millionth ledger close was achieved just weeks after hitting the 82 million threshold on August 21, showcasing an astonishing 1 million blocks processed in a mere 6 weeks and a total of 3 million blocks since May 27. The XRP ledger now stands at a staggering 83,025,000 blocks, having processed an additional 25,200 blocks in the 24 hours following the crossing of this monumental threshold. Hey guys, welcome back to Whiteboard Crypto Update. In today's video, we will talk about XRP's future. So be sure to stay focused as you surely don't want to miss out on this. If you are new to the channel, be sure to subscribe to the channel and turn on post notifications by hitting the bell so that you never miss any of our uploads. Please remember this is not a financial advice video. Moreover, according to XRP Scan data, the network has seen a remarkable surge in activity, completing 283,278 transactions on the current block, including an impressive 39,716 payments. This extraordinary growth can be attributed to the burgeoning interest in the XRPL, fueled by sustained ecosystem advancements. To contextualize this achievement, let's compare it to the Bitcoin network, which, despite being in existence 3 years longer than the XRPL, currently only boasts 810,859 blocks. Interestingly, the XRP ledger reached 810,859 blocks back in 2013, merely a year after its launch. This significant disparity in block numbers is primarily due to the XRPL's robust use cases, notably its support for cross-currency payments, payment channels, and multiple tokens. Additionally, the XRPL has expanded its functionality to accommodate various use cases, including the integration of NFTs through the XLS20 protocol implemented last October, enriching the NFT ecosystem on the ledger. The XRPL developer community remains resolute in enhancing these use cases, evident in the introduction of two pivotal amendments, the XLS30 and XLS39. The XLS30 amendment aims to bring a native automated market maker to the XRPL, while XLS39 will introduce a clawback feature, both of which are currently undergoing governance voting. Furthermore, the XRPL's theoretical transactions per second, TPS, was recently bolstered to an impressive 3,400, a notable stride in its technological capabilities. Weitzwind, the founder of XRPL Labs, highlighted this development in a post on X. Recall that XRPL Labs unveiled XAHA in August, featuring its native token initially denoted as XRP+. However, as the project gained traction, concerns arose regarding potential confusion with the original XRP token and compatibility issues with various exchanges and DeFi systems. In response to these valid concerns, Weitzwind engaged the community in a crucial decision-making process, organizing a Twitter poll on October 4th to gauge community input on renaming the XAHA native asset. The poll revealed overwhelming support for the new name XAH, with 73% of respondents favoring the change. Wind, in explaining the token's function, likened it to bus tickets, stating that XAH serves as the gas for the XAHA network, effectively deterring spam. If a market participant is not utilizing XAHA, they do not need to hold XAH. This aligns with a similar sentiment regarding the original XRP token, which exists as an asset for consuming resources on the XRPL. Users of the XAHA network must acquire XAH tokens to cover mandatory network fees, making spamming economically unviable for malicious actors. The process to acquire XAH differs from the conventional ICO method for token issuance, opting for a methodology rooted in the XPOP standard, a feature unveiled during the APX event, an XRPL developer conference. Acquiring XAH necessitates a burn-to-mint (B2M) exercise involving proof of burn from the mainnet. Users burn some XRP and present evidence of this burn to XAHA, receiving XAH tokens in return, eliminating the need for third-party swaps or associated risks. However, there is a caveat to this process. Validation messages are temporary and not archived in the ledger's history. If one misses these messages, they won't be able to create an XPOP, resulting in burned XRP without claiming XAH on XAHA. Now, turning our attention to the central focus for today, what lies ahead in the Ripple SDC lawsuit? It's been nearly 3 years since the SEC charged Ripple Labs with violating securities laws through the sales of XRP, an asset alleged to be an unregistered security. In July 2023, the court issued a much-anticipated summary judgment, with each party securing a partial victory. The court concluded that Ripple's institutional sales of XRP violated securities laws, but sales to retail investors did not. While many believe the lawsuit was nearing its end after this ruling, the SEC asked the court to certify an interlocutory appeal, contending that the July 13 ruling raised controlling legal questions, creating room for differences of opinion. However, the court denied the regulator's request, emphasizing that it had applied the relevant facts to the case. Now that the SEC's interlocutory appeal request has been denied, the pressing question within the XRP community is, what comes next? A trial is the subsequent event in the SEC's Ripple case. It's important to recall that the SEC's initial complaint included aiding and abetting charges against two of the company's executives, Chris Larson, chairman and co-founder, and Brad Garlinghouse, CEO. The trial has been scheduled, with the court ordering it to commence on April 23, 2024, in Courtroom 15D of the United States Courthouse, 500 Pearl Street, New York. Preceding the main trial, the court has also set a pretrial proceeding for the involved parties. The deadline for the parties to submit their pretrial filings and exhibits is set for December 4, 2023, with motions in limine due by the same date and oppositions scheduled to be filed by December 18, 2023. Additionally, a pretrial conference has been arranged by April 16, 2024 at 2:00 p.m., and the court has mandated the parties to engage in a settlement discussion on the matter at least an hour before the final pretrial conference. Interestingly, pro-XRP lawyer Fred Rispoli has provided insights into potential dates for other events in the lawsuit. In a recent tweet, attorney Rispoli speculated that the upcoming trial could last for at least 8 weeks or more. He noted that following the trial, the court would schedule a post-trial process, expected to conclude around September 2024. Since the SEC's request for an immediate appeal was denied, many legal experts predict that the regulator will file a full appeal after the trial concludes. In this regard, Rispoli forecasts that the appellate briefing to the Second Circuit will conclude around February 2025, anticipating a decision from the higher court by February 2026, a year later. Following the Second Circuit's decision, any aggrieved party may approach the Supreme Court for a revision. Attorney Rispoli has predicted that the Supreme Court could accept the review around February 2027. The journey ahead in this legal battle promises to be intricate and protracted, shaping the landscape for digital assets and regulatory frameworks in the years to come. Well, guys, that's all we have for you today. What are your thoughts on XRP? Get involved and let us know in the comments down below. If you guys like this video, then be sure to give this video a big thumbs up. Also, if you don't want to miss out on any new future videos, then be sure to click on the subscribe button and turn on the notification under this video, so that you're notified the next time we upload a video on the latest XRP and cryptocurrency news. Until the next video comes out, you can watch our other videos about XRP or other cryptocurrencies. Thank you for watching, and we will see you again in the next video. Goodbye.